1992. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ben's already figured out. What could I get on?
What?
I had a fat.
Mike, don't want fashion when you wear your back.
I have people watch me in the house.
Don't shoot any gum up there, Joe.
Good job, Bill.
This was supposed to be twice on the day.
We all catch fire and die. That is the guide to grads everywhere. Don't mind that. That's more grad activity.
Okay.
Thank you. You got a little remote there.
Back grab.
Thank you.
My report for that will be good. Thank you, Ms. Pitt, for your opening remarks. Dear special guests, graduates of 1997, parents and guardians of the graduates, staff members of the Digby Regional High School, ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the 14th annual graduation exercise at Digby Regional High School. Graduates, I invite you to relax and enjoy this evening. It is your evening as you graduate from high school, and we are all here to celebrate this activity with you. We are proud of our graduates tonight as they sit before you, young, enthusiastic, and determined to succeed, already at an important milestone in life. High school has prepared them with skills and knowledge for a lifetime of learning. They are prepared to take their places as a citizen in our country. They are knowledgeable about social and environmental problems in the world and will be looking for solutions with the problem-solving abilities that they have here at our school. They are able to work together to get worthwhile things done as they have shown during their school years. Some have represented our school very ably in a variety of extracurricular activities such as soccer, basketball, badminton, and yearbook, to name a few. Some have organized fundraising, dancing, spring break, yearbook, and graduation activities at our school this year with very minimal guidance from us. Some have shown an appreciation for the values of good citizenship in the community through the work as peer group representatives for younger students. They are all here tonight to be recognized by all of us for their achievement in completing their secondary education at this high school and for becoming the confident, mature young adults that for us. The world that they are entering poses many challenges for them collectively as part of a generation and individually as persons who will need to work hard for success. Yet I know I speak for all of us here tonight when I say that I am confident that success will not elude them as individuals and that collectively their generation will meet the challenges that today poses to them. They will continue to live up to the motto of our school, which in Latin is God intimus intimus, meaning in English, what we have begun, we shall finish. Yes, we are part of our 1997 graduates tonight, and we wish them the best of everything as they go forward to the life beyond the school. This graduation is a formal certification process. Each graduate will cross the platform and receive two documents. The first is a Digby Regional High School diploma indicating the program from which the student graduated and whether an honor standard was achieved. The second is a provincial certificate signed by the Minister of Education, which shows all the marks attained by the student in CEM credit courses. As each student is presented with these documents, I will indicate whether the student has received an honor stamp indicated by an A on the program, a merit award indicated by an M, or an academic award. Actually, Ms. Willowood is going to be doing this. Let me take a few minutes to explain what the different designations mean. An honor status is an academic distinction which requires that the student must have taken English plus four other courses at the same level. The average of the credits must be at least 18% with no mark below 65%. A merit award is given for various types of special achievements in class and is not based on marks alone. Eight nominations by teachers over the 2 semesters are necessary for achievement award. Activity awards are given for different levels of participation and leadership in school activities based on a point system. A silver D designated by an A represents 30 points and a 12th D designated by an A by a C rather, for schedule represents 15 points. That is just an explanation of how these different things work. The formal process of presenting the certificates to the graduates begins now. I would like to call upon Mr. Chief and Ms. Littlewood to assist me in this present task. Ms. Littlewood will announce the name of the graduate and I will present the certificate. Mr. Chief will ensure that the documents end up in the right hand. During the presentation of the certificate, one of our students, Ashley Cronin, will play the background music.
Thank you. money on Maria Bravery. On